In this video, we will review our COVID procedures that we are implementing at Berea High School for the 2020-2021 school year. Our goal at Berea High School is to provide as much normalcy, including in-person education and extracurricular activities, as is possible for our students while following the mandates and guidance of state, local, and public health authorities to ensure the health of our students, employees, and communities. What is COVID-19? COVID-19, also referred to as the coronavirus, is an infectious disease caused by a virus that can spread from person to person. The virus that causes COVID-19 is a new coronavirus that has spread throughout the world. Older people and those with underlying medical problems are at higher risk of developing serious illness. However, anyone can catch COVID-19 and become seriously ill. One way to reduce the spread of COVID-19 is to wear mask cloth face coverings. Face coverings are an additional tool that individuals should use to help slow the spread of COVID-19, but does not replace other social distancing requirements. Those instructed not to wear a cloth face covering or mask by a medical provider should provide written documentation to Mr. Noel. Acceptable reusable face covering options include neck gaiter, tightly woven fabric such as cotton t-shirts. Self-provided face masks shall not be a distraction to the environment. No face covering mask will be permitted that display profanity, suggestive phrases, or advertisements for or messages or pictures depicting or suggesting alcohol, tobacco, drugs, or sex. Face covering mask must not be obscene, profane, lewd, vulgar, indecent, or offensive. Upon arrival to school, students are required to wear a face covering before entering the building. Students should ensure that their face covering is properly worn, as well as making sure that they are wearing their school ID. Students that choose to eat breakfast in the cafeteria will proceed to the cafeteria line while following social distancing guidelines. After they have their food, then they are to sit on a seat that has a blue piece of tape. These seats have been marked to ensure that we are following social distancing guidelines. After students are seated and socially distanced, then they may remove their mask. This is the same procedure that we will use during all of our lunches. Students that drive to school are asked to remain in their cars until 8:30 if they are not going to eat breakfast in the cafeteria. At 8:30, administration will open the doors that are closest to the student parking lot. Students may enter through this door and go directly to their first block class. Students must have on a face covering and their student ID must be clearly visible. Bus riders and car riders that choose not to eat breakfast in the cafeteria will be directed to the gym. Students will enter the gym and look for blue tape on the bleachers that has been designated as a seat for students. Once students are seated at the blue tape, then they may remove their face coverings since they will be socially distanced. Students will remain in the gym until we dismiss for students to proceed to their first block class. Throughout the school, we have placed signs as reminders to social distance while moving through the halls and while using the stairs. Students are asked to always keep to the right so that we are always moving in one direction on the right side. Keeping space between you and others is one of the best tools we have to avoid being exposed to this virus and slowing its spread. Social distancing, also called physical distancing, means keeping space between yourself and others. To practice social distancing, stay 6 feet or 2 arms' length from other people. Another way to reduce the spread of COVID-19 is proper hand hygiene. Wash your hands often with soap and water for at least 20 seconds. If soap and water are not readily available, use a hand sanitizer that contains at least 60% alcohol. Cover all surfaces of your hands and rub them together until they feel dry. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. Always wash your hands when they are visibly soiled, after using the bathroom, after blowing your nose, coughing, or sneezing, and after coming into contact with any chemicals. We have installed water bottle filling stations throughout our school. All of the water fountains have been disabled. Students are asked to bring in their own water bottles to use during the school day. Do not allow your water bottle to come into contact with the nozzle when refilling. Place your water bottle under the nozzle. It is motion activated, so it will begin refilling your bottle without you having to touch anything. Once your water bottle is filled, then remove it from the filling station. The water will turn off automatically. Dismissal will be staggered to allow us to maintain social distancing and reduce the amount of traffic leaving the building at one time. We will announce at 3:35 for all car drivers, walkers, and athletes to be dismissed. We will also announce any buses that have arrived in the bus loop. At that time, those students will leave their fourth block and move towards their appropriate exit. Student drivers are asked to go directly to their cars and leave campus. All students that walk home are also asked to exit the building and leave campus. Athletes will go directly to their assigned practice area. Any bus riders will exit through the athletic hallway doors into the bus loop and load directly onto their bus. Please remember that students will need to wear face coverings as they are moving through the building. At 3:40, we will dismiss car riders from fourth block. Students that are car riders are asked to stand on the sidewalk and properly social distance from other students. Please pay attention to the car line so that you can identify your car and quickly get into it. Students are asked to keep face coverings on outside if they are unable to maintain proper social distance. We will continue to announce buses as they arrive while bus riders are waiting in their fourth block class. At 4 p.m., we will announce for any remaining bus riders to move to the cafeteria, where we will follow the same procedures for sitting and maintaining social distance that we follow for breakfast and lunch. We have a lot of new and vastly different norms. Our primary goal at Berea High School is to provide a safe and healthy environment for our teachers, staff, and students. In order to accomplish this, we need everyone to help remind each other to follow safety protocols. We are fully confident that we will be able to teach our students proper safety and social distancing protocols. As always, if you have any questions or concerns, you can contact your grade level administrator or Mr. Noel. We are looking forward to a great school year. Go Dawgs!